Germany here. You don't speak German?
No, I speak English.
Yeah.
This is part of the performance. If you don't want to be filmed, you must go.
Thank you.
We have those people in the circle, which are the most instrumentalized people of the room, including you. And I would suggest that people that are outside the circle, we can ask questions to people that are inside the circle. And after that, we can do the other way around.
You can also not do what she said inside the circle, for example. You can do something else. That I disagree, that we should do something else. I don't know, I want this decision to be collective. For once, at least, let's try to find something to do all together.
You mean like taking you by the hand to do a real circle? A real circle.
What doesn't there always need to be a leader at some point? Maybe? Is that the question?
For me, yes.
Good for? Are they to get the people out of the circle? Why do we need to have a separation?
I mean, an obvious question is why do you feel more instrumentalized than we do? Why do you feel instrumentalized so much that you stand closer to the center than I do?
I think it's quite subjective. How you place yourself inside and you, like, it's very dependent on what you think about yourself. So maybe you feel more instrumentalized than I do, that your measure is different than mine. And also, like, how the circle was placed was pretty random, so.
But the measure was standing in the center, very instrumentalized, standing in the...
Yeah, but still, you know...
Yeah,
it's not the same for everyone.
True.
So I feel it's kind of...
It's not the same to be instrumentalized.
Yes.
Yeah.
So we can do nothing without a master. Nothing. There is nothing to do without a master. Anyone can choose just to leave the job. Anyone. Like, there's no pressure on anybody. I think it's a pressure on ourselves that we want to participate in an instrumental or into like a tryout that we did here. We want to participate in this art. So I think that's the only pressure for yourself, that you want to stay here. If somebody really feels that he's doing something he doesn't want to do, he's free to leave. So I think the only pressure that we have is the pressure upon ourselves, that we want to participate and we want to do everything we can to participate and to share this activity. So I don't think there's really a pressure or instrumental for anybody here to do whatever the group tells them to do. So it's not really that we're captured and it's not really that we're free. It's like a gray zone in between.
Does anyone think we should turn it off?
I'd rather be not
there. I don't care. I can do a show.
Okay. Yeah, it's interesting that the two people who wanted the cameras turned off are of a particular demographic that's not the same as yours.
Yeah.
don't know, we might feel more visible than other people. Maybe we feel more visible than other people.
I have black hair as well.
Maybe
people
That's how I felt.
I think the minute the camera is pointed on you, I think that's kind of pressure. Like, you said something, should we turn off the camera, and immediately the camera turned on you. So, of course, that's some kind of a pressure the camera puts on you. But
I think the camera makes a division between the people on the live stream and us. But if we turn that off, the division is gone.
I think you just got a lot of hearts. I think you just got a lot of hearts. Why you said that, many hearts pumping up from. The watchers like what you said.
Why do you worry about people you don't even see?
We could all come back.
Okay, I think only four people watch us. But you got a couple of hearts when you said that. So.
Strange, but like it's like what's happening all the time. And I think people actually don't mind that it's happening.
And the camera just shows the truth. I mean, it's just what happens. It doesn't matter if it's, if the camera is here or not.
It doesn't matter.
So that's why it made me.
Somebody says, stop focus on the camera and start play the theater, people. You all look fine here in New York City.
Well, New York City, you're not here.
What time is it in New York City?
6 hours less.
6 hours
about 12. You should go to work.
Not on Sunday, no.
Turn off Facebook and start working.
It's not Facebook, it's Periscope.
Okay. What?
It's Periscope.
I want to ask somebody on the live stream if they think they're instrumentalized.
No answer so far?
And they got back to work.
Would it be possible that somebody else films?
No.
May I?
No. No?
Okay. Could be more democratic if somebody... May I? Yeah. Thank you.
You can go outside.
Sorry?
You can go outside.
No, I don't want to. No.
It's too expensive. Okay.
Do you want me?
How do you feel like being watched?
Well, it's interesting because I perform, right, for a profession, but in this space, I kind of want to hide, actually.
Because it's private now?
Yeah, it's...
You feel
I mean, when I perform, I'm a character, right? I'm not Talia, I guess. But this is a very different kind of feeling.
And if you perform on stage and there's a camera, is it different?
Yes. I mean...
when
it's a text form, and no, it's the role of something to say. Now we have to create it in this moment.
But when it's, but when it was, when for example, when something was live streamed, right, I felt enormous pressure to get everything perfect.
Okay. Because it's,
it would be forever.
Yes, it's forever on YouTube.
Yeah.
You singing the wrong note. But
yes. Yeah. Or playing the wrong note. Yeah.
And it's hard to forget everything else. Mm-hmm. On a film, on a tape, or anything. You can go back and see it. It was just like you remembered or maybe you remembered wrong. And I say something here, and nobody films it. Tomorrow, I guess, probably don't even remember what I just said. But now you can go back.
But I want to ask you, what do you think of the state when you play yourself and someone is... Why do you feel like it's having elaborated in your thoughts?
Maybe it has something to do with like your private sphere and your public sphere. I don't know, it's actually something I think a lot about these things.
What kind of information do you share? You share the same information that they are on Facebook mostly, like what we do, our face, and our name.
But I don't have a control. I control what I put on Facebook.
This is under copyright. You can do whatever you want with the video. You can download it, manipulate it.
But I cannot control what scene is on the film. It's somebody else filming, right?
The opposite. You can control even what is going on here. You can say something, imply something, and you can control the room.
I cannot control all of you.
You propose something to do together.
Proposal, it's not control.
Is that not a judge?
I mean, I think to me, I don't know. I just think that the way, I think the larger question is the way that like technology has changed everything, really, about how we conduct ourselves. And I don't know. That's for me a big thing that I think that I think about a lot. How we interact, how we coordinate, how we think, how we plan. I think it's infiltrated kind of all aspects of our lives. That's what I see this whole video conversation is really like. Maybe
the
larger box.
I still think it's only one aspect of the experiment that we're doing here, because in the beginning we didn't really notice the camera. I didn't really notice it. I think it's, it has to do with one aspect is the recording, the video, and the other aspect is the pressure that you feel. Like if somebody gets up and says his name and says, nah, let's all do that, if you don't do it, it looks strange. So I think it's like a dual experiment here. I think the recording is not even the main thing of it. I think it's very important. Of course, it's a very big question these days, you know, the recording, all the data.
Sorry.
The first one, because I would like to leave.
Me too.
Would you like to tell us your feedback before you go?
Yes. It was wonderful in the beginning, and I'm bored.
Oh,
yeah.
Can you say why?
I'm bored because I have the feeling we started to do things together, and now we have this discussion about social medias, and I would like to do things together instead of discussing this, because we are surrounded by it.
So you can suggest it.
Yeah, but I did it. We did something. And now I think for me, my time is over here. I can't participate something, so I would like to leave.
And would you rather leave or rather do something else?
But we still have 15 minutes, we can do something together. The group that we are here now, we will never get together again. We have people from New York here, we have people from all over Germany.
I would like to do something.
Yes, yes.
But discussions for me, every day for hours, nothing happens, and I think the most important thing is to do things together. So, you did something, I'm very pleased, so, but I didn't want to disturb you, so I have to, because I have to say reasons why I would like to leave.
I agree.
You agree? Yeah. If you try to disturb him, and you realize, no, we can't, so...
I want to leave for the same reason.
So, but perhaps you want to discuss. I don't know. I'm now in a disharmony with you. Yeah. Let's try harmony. I don't know how.
We have a lot of people that sit here, and you can go in a different direction.
Okay.
If they want to. I can't sing, I can't dance. So.
What can everyone, what
yeah.
can we do? Everyone can.
Yeah. Without revealing too much information.
Is the big brother having to answer?
No, I'm trying to remember this animal that puts his head when he's afraid inside the dirt.
House, not an animal.
I feel that we try to avoid the conflict because it's very complicating or like a lot of things to say, so we don't have, let's just do whatever. And I think this problem is just hidden behind because it continues to be there and just hide it and it's okay. Yeah. We can act normally, we can play. Let's do music.
Let's do what?
Music.
Okay. Do we need a master to do something together?
No.
But I think you had an idea of how we have to act now. You are in the middle of a discussion about social medias. I disturb it because I have to tell you my reasons to leave. And I said I would like to act. So if you don't want to, you have to tell. You have to say, no, it's better to do this discussion about it. Okay. So
we can
discuss and...
We can vote.
I'm not a voter. We can do that.
We could.
Or, or we can
vote.
Of course we can.
Leaving is much more easier than changing.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Just one question. Why did you have to give an explanation why you want to leave?
Pardon?
Why did you have to give an explanation why you want to leave?
It's a part of your space.
Yeah,
no. And I did it instead of going out.
Because I saw some other people
go
out
me
and
too.
I didn't know that you had to explain it.
Yes,
okay.
And they didn't want to. So I came here. See? And I interrupt everything.
So, okay.
So let's start another thing or the discussion.
I think it would be nice to really succeed to stay here 1 hour. I think that's... it's just me.
That's the main thing is to take this off or to shut it down or...
Just ignore it.
No.
No?
Oh, it was written in front of the door. Everybody could knew that there is a camera. You could think about it before.
It was not my question. I would like to do something.
I didn't know about that
either.
Yeah. So.
It is written on the door.
Okay.
We're still talking about it.
Yeah, but we don't have to do it like in a big group. We can just create like small groups, and then I would love to hear like what he has to say about the documentary, but I don't want him to feel pressured and everybody listening and everybody recording. You love it.
I love it. It's great.
How long do you stay in Kassel?
I'm here for an entire week.
I lived in Boston for a while.
Wow.
So
think that today we started with this mutation, it became like a natural thing, like someone started sharing information in his language and other people started doing the same. But then we had this moment of that we realized maybe the levels of instrumentalization that we live in our lives and in the performance. And after that, we discovered that there is a pattern on how people tend to act in a space like that, and we tend to follow and imitate each other because it's I don't know why. I don't know. Let's say that I don't know why. I can only speculate on why. But I've noticed it. And when you try to break this mediation and you say something like, "What we do without a master," or "Let's avoid that," "Let's do it," then you are in the conflict. We are in the conflict. Then, if something happens, is that we try to abolish conflict by normalizing, like by turning back to the before we knew situation. Before we knew what was up. So this is my reading for today.
This is why?
My checkout.
He starts for
today. Yeah, so I would like to share also some thoughts about the beginning to the initial suggestion, which was to do something normal, something that seemed very normal in the performance space. So. It seemed like at first we were all acting as the audience, leaving some space in the center for action to happen, and then people started to perform in a way by introducing themselves. The language barrier became visible at some moment when someone says that maybe we should speak in English because not everybody speaks German, for example. And it seemed like every time someone was making a move and people were following the same pattern. And after that, I find interesting the fact that you said that this was us being together. And despite this moment of togetherness, right now we are finding a very, very difficult to be together again. Even though we are speaking about it and trying to find a solution, it seemed that in the beginning it was something more intuitive or something that came out of us without even thinking, and now that we're starting to think about it, it becomes very hard.
But I don't think it was intuitive at first, because, for example, the circle and this sound, there was somebody that proposed it, and just everybody followed, because there was not the question of do we need a master to do something collective, then the question was implied afterwards, but yes, it was a very good thing to propose to do something collectively, but still it was not a collective decision of what we really needed to do. For example, me, I didn't have a need to do this at the time. But I just followed the group. Also, I didn't have the need to introduce myself. I just followed the group. And actually, this was very interesting. I don't know how you came up to the idea to introduce ourselves, but it was interesting because we always say that that we have thought about it during these concerts, that we tend to perform ourselves in a place like this. We tend to show another aspect of ourselves in different contexts. And in this one, that it is very, I don't know, well structured in a way, we tend to perform even more. And so when we left a space, a central space for performance, and everybody went to introduce themselves, it was very clear that we were, in a way, performing ourselves. So I found it interesting that you came up with this suggestion.
Of course, yeah, the German was, I don't know, I think most of the people here are German speakers, and of course it was not in a collective direction that we all speak our own language without caring if other people can understand us or not. So, yeah, of course there was some pressure when we asked to think about how instrumentalized we are. Of course then the whole situation became harder and heavier, and with the discussion it got only worse, I think. But on the other hand, I don't think that in the previous situation we were in a collective comfortable feeling that may have occurred after asking how much instrumentalized we think we are. I think it got worse in, yeah.
But I think your inner circle made it, because you did a division between people inside and outside.
Yeah, I'm not saying it's bad.
Okay. No, but the
inner circle.
No,
but I'm not saying it's bad.
Yeah, but at that moment it started to become worse.
Mm-hmm.
Because we were divided before we tried to do something together, and now we were divided into groups, those inside and those outside.
But this was together is now, you say it's not worse to do something together. I mean, what does it mean, worse? To feel comfortable, not comfortable?
Not comfortable.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is it about feeling comfortable here?
No. I say this is not bad, feeling uncomfortable, but I said it got worse, it got more intense. That's what I meant. The uncomfortability.
Yeah.
Maybe it got more intense as time went by. With me.
For me, the moment when it got worse or got more intensive, it got for me better, because I had the feeling that everybody says what he really thinks and what he is. And if when we just had the circle and stepped to each side, I did it, and what you said I didn't need it to do. But now I was quite a long time, and that's exactly what I am. And I think the moments for me were important to have the chance to feel who I am. And I had a little bit the feeling to see who the others are.
And I would agree, because the moment when we started talking, it was kind of the chance to reflect on ourselves and to look back on what happened, or on what's happening here right now, and what kind of situation it is. So I think to start talking and discussing, it's actually very good to